Once you've created your clinical query, you can search a literature search database like PubMed to help you find articles to answer your question. Although PubMed is a free website from the U.S. government, you should access it using the FAU link so that you're connected with FAU subscriptions. The FAU website is library.fau.edu/medical. Then click on Library Resources, and you can search for PubMed, and then apply. Once you click on this PubMed link, you'll be brought to the FAU version of PubMed. What we're going to do here is a more advanced search of PubMed. So click where it says Advanced underneath the search box. Using the Advanced Search Builder, you can take the PICO elements from your clinical question and search for them in PubMed. Let me show you what that looks like. For example, systemic lupus erythematosus. Remember, let's write it out instead of using the acronym. And what I'm going to do here is instead of searching for it right away, I want to add it to my history. And the reason why I'm doing this is I want to show you what PubMed is doing behind the scenes. It's something they introduced about a year or two ago that's really cool. You have to go to where it says details and click on this arrow. But when you do that, it shows you, even though you typed in systemic lupus erythematosus, it has chosen the best search terms that it thinks work for your search. It will map it to the MeSH term, which is the standardized term they use in PubMed and Medline, and it will also suggest other keywords. You can see here that they've put together all the ands and ors for you to come up with as many synonyms and terms for systemic lupus erythematosus for you. Sorry, I shouldn't have chosen a word that was a bit of a tongue twister. Okay, so it's important to look here because it is a computer, so it doesn't always get this information right. So for example, if you wanted to search for articles about motorcycle accidents being more likely to occur with white helmets or black helmets, if you type the word white into PubMed, it will automatically map it to something like European ancestry, which is not what you're looking for if you're looking for white helmets. So you always want to check the details and see what sort of search it's created for you here. Okay, so that's what it looks like behind the scenes. Earlier, I also typed in our other terms, joint pain. You can see it mapped it to the MeSH term here, Plaquenil, also known as hydroxychloroquine, so that was good. It got your synonyms here, connected with OR, and turmeric. Now, it also tells you how many articles you'll get if you search each term separately. And you can see there's the least articles out here about turmeric. If I try to search all four elements of my PICO at once with this particular search, there aren't going to be enough articles left. I would get zero results. If that happens to you, I recommend searching for your problem and your intervention first, because those are the two most important pieces. Now, if you have something that's more common, like if you're looking at hypertension or ACE inhibitors, you'll probably have more than enough articles to search through, probably too many. But on a topic like this where there's not as much, I might just start with two terms. So let's add this to my search. Under Actions, I can click Add Query, and it's added it to the box. And I want to search systemic lupus erythematosus and turmeric. So again, I'm going to click on these three dots underneath Actions, and I'm going to add it with an and, because I want both terms in my search. ORs are used for synonyms, and mostly PubMed can map those synonyms for you, so you don't really have to worry about it. This time, I can add it to my history, or I could just search for it right away. If I add to history, I can see there's only 10 results. I searched this before, so I knew there wasn't going to be that many that have these two words. So like I was saying, if I also tried to add in joint pain and Plaquenil, I would get zero results back. To view the results, I could have either chosen search, or I can just click on the results here, these 10. Now I could look through these to see which ones might be of interest to me. So for example, this first one here, I can click on it. It's a systematic review, which means it's a review that was completed in a systematic manner that looks at the studies that looked at dietary intervention and systemic lupus erythematosus. This might be of interest. Now, to get to the actual article, I can click View Full Text, especially if I'm on campus, this works really well. But if you're not on campus, there's also this Find It at FAU button that links you to our resources. If you are not logged in to PubMed through FAU, you won't see this, so make sure you're coming through our website. So I click on Find It at FAU, and then I can see that the library has purchased this from Taylor and Francis, so I can click on the link here. I already signed in, but if I hadn't done so, I would sign in with my FAU username and password. I'm brought to the journal's homepage, and now I can click on the PDF to save this article to my desktop or my iPad.